When we think about what scares us, a few things come to mind. The thought of a zombie apocalypse, a meteor the size of Texas hurtling towards Earth, and how Disney is going to salvage this new Star Wars movie really put us on edge. Good luck, J.J. Abrams. Honestly, we're rooting for you on this one. But what if we told you that back in the early 2000s, what scared Americans more than any supernatural or world-ending scenario was an envelope? You heard that right, Brainiacs. But more specifically, it wasn't the envelope itself that scared people, but rather the fear of what could be inside. Today, we take a look back on our nation's history to talk about the infamous anthrax attacks in 2001, to hopefully shed some light on exactly what anthrax is, how it affects the body, and what you can do if you become infected. Most Americans first heard the word anthrax just about two decades ago, when they were sitting at home watching TV. The media was in an uproar when, 1 week after the 9/11 attacks on our nation, letters were mailed to news media offices and Democratic senators containing a fine white powder as well as a threatening note. The powder was laced with anthrax spores in the hope of not only infecting those who opened the letters, but causing widespread panic across the nation. But this still begs the question, what exactly is anthrax? Let's put on our scientist caps for a second. Anthrax is an infectious disease caused by a rod-shaped bacteria known as Bacillus anthracis. In the wild, it can be found in the soil, and most commonly affects domestic and wild animals. Many times, cows, sheep, and deer that are wandering around grazing on their favorite patch of grass are the ones most likely to catch this deadly disease. And when we say anthrax is serious, we absolutely mean it. After all, in the 2001 bioterrorist attacks, known as Amerithrax, 5 people died and 17 were sickened. So what happens if anthrax spores enter your body? Well, once they are breathed in or ingested, the spores become activated, which can take between 1 and 6 days, but it's not unheard of for the spores to remain in the body for 60 days before becoming activated. After that, they will then produce the anthrax bacteria. Now, these nasty intruders will start to multiply, and multiply, and multiply, and eventually spread throughout the body to produce toxins, or poisons, which will cause you to get really, really sick. We're talking fever and chills, vomiting, aches, extreme tiredness, and even blisters or sores that can start to swell and have a black center. Really nasty stuff. But fear not, Brainiacs. Now that we know what we're dealing with, let's learn exactly how to fight this infection. First off, see your doctor. Tell them exactly why you think you have anthrax and where you might have gotten it from. If inhaled, they will be able to detect it through an x-ray of your chest and then confirm it through a blood sample. Your doctor will also prescribe antibodies to fight these nasty bacteria. The old 1-2 punch from some good old-fashioned penicillin will usually do the trick. Doctors usually recommend a 60-day treatment of antibodies to ensure that any and all spores that are hanging out just waiting to activate will receive a full dose of the treatment. Better to be safe than sorry. Oh, before we forget, one important thing to note about someone infected with anthrax that will definitely relieve some of the stress, it's not contagious. You heard that right, not even in the slightest. So luckily, friends and family can help you out by driving to the hospital and staying with you during your recovery and not worry about getting sick themselves. So, now we know exactly what anthrax is and how to deal with it. And you know exactly what to do if you are ever unsure about a strangely addressed letter. Because when it comes down to it, those attackers in 2001 just wanted to cause fear across our nation. The fear of the unknown, to be exact. But, to quote one of our favorite Harry Potter books, fear of a name increases fear of the thing itself. And we hope your newfound knowledge has put your mind at ease, because you know what to do. We will see you next time, Brainiacs.